What's up, guys? I'm Virginia Lohman. Thanks for tuning in. Today, we're in the studio with Alfonso Herrera from Fox's hit show, The Exorcist.
Thank you so much for being here.
Of course. So I want to ask you, obviously, a few questions about the show. What was it like preparing for your role of Thomas Ortega?
Well, specifically, it was it's a big responsibility, but at the same time, it's a great opportunity to show and to be part of a show that in a certain way is connected to this holy grail of horror. But
it's sort of the mecca of horror,
it
right?
It is.
The Exorcist was probably one of the first horror films I ever saw. So
how did you react? I watched it when I was 10 years old.
Yeah.
With my little brother. He was eight years old. So it was a very peculiar experience.
Yeah.
But what I can say is that in terms of exorcisms, I tried to investigate a little bit with people from the Catholic Church.
Okay.
But they were a little bit hermetic with the information they wanted to provide.
Right.
Or basically, they didn't provide any of it.
Yeah, I was going to say, I'm surprised they said
anything. They didn't provide any information.
They're like, we don't talk about these things.
But thanks to the great team that we had, Rupert Wyatt, who was the director of the pilot, Jeremy Slater, who is the creator and writer, Rolling Jones, who is also one of the producers, but he was also very involved in the writing process, we managed to build something very grounded with three-dimensional characters. And as you said, if we understood very well our characters, then the stimuli would come naturally.
Yeah,
but we
sure.
had a blast in doing that show.
Awesome. So, I mean, obviously you said that you watched the original Exorcist with your little brother.
I did.
Do you guys have conversations about, like, I can't believe that I'm actually playing this role now?
I was born in Mexico City,
okay.
But then I moved to Guadalajara, where my mother lives.
Mm-hmm.
And there was this thing in Mexican TV that you could see like different like trilogies on Saturdays.
Okay.
So they did The Exorcist 3, 2, and 1. They saved the last,
oh my gosh,
the best one at the very end.
Yeah.
And we watched the last one.
Okay.
When I was 10.
Just
was
the
saying,
last one, or you sat there and watched
three
in one scene?
No, we watched just the first movie. And we were terrified. It was a very peculiar experience.
Yeah.
We couldn't sleep for 2 weeks. But because it's very well done.
Yeah.
And especially it has to do with a lot of psychological horror.
Right. I mean, I think that's the scary thing about the movie, right? You, half of the time, it's not like you're fighting vampires or ghouls.
Right.
Like, you're literally fighting, like, demons, but then also some, like, your character battles inner demons as well.
That's right.
So,
and we are trying to explore not just the macrocosmos, which is trying to fight these entities
right.
and these negative energies that are around.
Right.
We're trying also to portray these inner demons that each and every single human being has, which are fears, doubts.
Right.
And those fears and doubts are little gates or little windows that provide these bigger entities
right.
to get in. And also, I mean, we're trying to portray the battle between light and darkness. This
For
is
sure.
a battle that has existed since
the beginning of time. Yeah.
And in a certain way, this story is not the exception. With the biggest and with a great challenge, which is a connection to this holy grail of
horror. Did you do anything to sort of, like, get into the mode or mentality of being Alex Ortega when you got to set? And when you got there, were you Thomas Ortega.
Yeah.
Were you Thomas Ortega the entire day? Or, you know, when the film stopped rolling, did you sort of, like, get back into your own, like, I'm back to being Alfonso right now? Or did you, like, stick to your role all day?
No. I think it's good to just
separate
things. And I'll tell you why. When we were about to shoot, I thought, okay, we're gonna shoot The Exorcist. We're gonna explain, and we're gonna enter into this dark and dense
right.
world. And I thought that the atmosphere on set, probably it was going to be like that. But actually, it was totally the opposite.
Okay,
it was amazing. We had a blast shooting in Chicago.
So there was, like, laughing on set.
Yes.
Not, like, crying.
Between takes,
okay.
obviously, between takes.
Right.
But it was a great experience. And also having the possibility to share a set with Ben Daniels, which is an amazing actor, with Gina Davis, which is a huge
actress
and movie
cast.
Icon, not just in the States, but everywhere.
Yeah.
So it was an amazing opportunity.
Awesome. A little bit more just about you. I mean, obviously your career has sort of like spanned everything. When it comes to entertainment, you are the entire package. So what are you planning on doing next? Like, do you want to like venture into directing, maybe some screenwriting? Like, do you have, what are your other passions outside of acting or moving forward?
Well, I there's a I don't know how to say it. There's a sentence in Latin America that for you to run properly, you need to crawl first, in a good way.
You have
So
to crawl before you walk, I
that's
think is the
right.
equivalent
And you have
here.
to crawl in a very good way, so next you can walk better. So I think that I am very, very fortunate with the projects that I have right now. It doesn't matter where it goes. I just finished a movie in Spain, and it was a great story. And also, there's another season, another show that is going to be aired, which I am in. It's called Sense8, and the platform is Netflix. So
Oh,
I'm
that's
happy. Yeah,
amazing.
I'm
That's
happy with the
exciting.
projects that I have right now, and yeah, that's
So you're
it.
good with it right
Yeah,
now.
yeah,
You're
yeah.
not like rushing anything.
Yeah, the project will come. The
How do
project
you
will
sort
come.
of like find the time to balance all of this? I mean, between remembering your lines as Thomas to like filming all of these new projects, how are you sort of just finding a balance in your own life?
I have no idea.
Oh gosh.
I have no idea. But I just do it. I just do it, and I love my work, and I feel very fortunate again to find interesting characters, interesting stories, scripts that, no matter the nationality of it, are great. And sometimes the story itself is the one that surprises you.
Talk to me about finding the great scripts. I mean, I imagine that your publicist probably like sends you projects all the time. Like, what do you think about this? What do you think
Yeah.
about this? But obviously, you don't take all of
You know,
them.
once I heard something that is in overall, like, there are three things that exist when you're going to choose a project. It's script, director, and cast. You can live with two of them.
But you can't have all three.
If there's a project where it has the three of them, you should
You
take
take
it
that right away.
immediately.
Okay, got it.
You can live with two, and if it has just one, probably you should consider it.
Okay.
But that's like a interesting resume.
Sort of
Is that
maybe like
well
a
said?
motto to go with.
Sometimes I get lost in translation because
No, it's okay.
of the language. But it's very helpful, and also very important not to judge the project. You just have to be open to any story, to any character, and not to judge
You
your
have to be an
character. You have
artist.
to embrace your character, and you have to defend it, even though sometimes you do not accept or you do not agree with what he's doing inside the story.
Do you have a dream role?
I have a dream role. No, I
No.
just let stories and characters
Come to
surprise me,
you.
yeah. But the biggest thing and the most important thing is characters and stories to challenge you.
Got it.
You cannot sit on a comfortable zone. If that happens, you have to keep moving.
Okay, last question. Obviously, here at the news, we're in New York, so I have to ask you something about New York. Is there one thing in particular that you think just makes New York like this magical place for you?
Oh, traffic jams. Oh
Oh,
yeah, they're
what?
so magical. They were
Traffic
magical. It's a magic.
That is hilarious.
Because really, drivers, they do magic
They do.
to
The
make
taxi
it to
drivers
make
in
it on time.
particular, I will say that,
That's
yes.
magic. That's like alchemia,
That's
pure
true.
alchemia. So, but New York, it's an amazing city. I really enjoy being here, and it, in a certain way, portrays also what the U.S. is like,
For sure.
the
Very diverse.
very diverse. And I think that is a huge strength,
For sure.
and that is something that I admire from the city.
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for being here. This was great talking to
Thank
you.
you.
And thank you guys for tuning in.
We are naming you one of our breakout stars of the fall, and I want to give you this award. Entertainment Tonight's Fall Television
Wow.
2016
That is such a
Breakout
cool
Star.
thing. Nice. Thank you very, very much.
At Entertainment Tonight, we watch so many of the new shows that are coming out, and there's always a few people that jump off the screen at us.
That's an understatement. E.T.'s fall TV breakout star, Alfonso Herrera, is warding off demonic spirits in the TV version of The Exorcist.
You're afraid. Yeah, you should be too.
The movie gave us all nightmares. Alfonso and the rest of the cast of this series Well, they're planning on doing the same.
You're touching the holy grail of horror films. So I felt very, very lucky to be part of it. But at the same time, I was a little bit afraid because it's a show that talks about darkness.
Father, that was a lovely service.
Want to talk sometime? My door is always open.
Let's be real. Alfonso is one handsome priest. But sorry, ladies, he's taken.
Okay, Alfonso, the ladies are going to want to know, because when they see those eyes and see that smile on screen, I see a ring. Are you married?
I am with, I am with my half. There's someone.
All right, everybody, back off. He's taken, okay?
Frank Langella. I saw him when I was in college in Dracula. I had a huge crush on him. I had a picture of him from the newspaper on my wall.
I was in Rio de Janeiro once in 2012, and I was in this restaurant, and suddenly Ronaldinho entered the restaurant, and I just couldn't believe it. I was like completely frozen, and I went with him, and I introduced myself, and I did the whole thing.
Ellen Burstyn, but not because of this movie. I was 15, and I saw The Last Picture Show, and everybody else was like, oh, Silver Shepherd, ooh. And she didn't do it for me. I was like, I don't know, I kind of dig the mom. She messed me up for a good long time. She really did.
Pues Leti es una chica que viene de provincia a estudiar en la universidad, empieza a estudiar pedagogía. En el primer año de carrera, su mejor amiga le presenta a José Montaño, quien está estudiando, un chico muy guapo, quien está estudiando Derecho, y pues ellos se enamoran y empiezan una relación y empiezan a tener hijos muy pronto. Hay que ya es mucha pasión y mucho. Entonces la historia comienza a partir de que ellos ya son una familia, tienen tres hijos. Leti se dedica un poco a estar en casa con los hijos y él trabaja muchísimo para poder sostener a la familia. En ese momento, solo se cuenta ese pedacito, ¿no? Te dan estos antecedentes. Y empieza con que somos esta familia y a él le ofrecen un trabajo en la Procuraduría General de la República que nos va a cambiar la vida. Él acepta este trabajo y empieza a estar un poco ausente. Entonces la relación empieza a cambiar. Leti se tiene que encargar ella sola de la familia. Empieza a sentir su ausencia, una persona con la que ha estado 15 años cada noche en su cama.
En algún momento te deja seducir como policía infiltrado también por la mafia. ¿Cómo fue, cómo es para el personaje este juego de sentimientos en el que estás dispuesto a hacer el bien, por eso te infiltras como el daño? Pero a su vez, conoces la amistad, la empatía.
Es que la raíz es la raíz del por qué él decide tomar esta... Él decide esto, es por su familia, para darles una estabilidad. Entonces, cuando él está totalmente inmerso en estas... en este mundo y en este núcleo tan ajeno a lo que es Pepe Montaño, pues se empieza a... Al principio es un shock, pero después poco a poco empieza a darse cuenta que no es tan ajeno ese mundo, que le empieza a seducir este mundo y este barrio y estas transacciones medio
chuecas,
truculentas, y se empieza a perder y se empieza a olvidar un poco de él, y se empieza a olvidar un poco de quién era este padre de familia. Y es ahí donde viene también el conflicto, el poder él también volverse a encontrar, el reencontrarse. Y creo que fue una experiencia muy grata interpretar y compartir el set con Damián Alcázar, que es un gran actor y que es muy querido por absolutamente por todo el gremio y por toda la industria, y también con Dagoberto, con Hernán Mendoza. Entonces fue un gran privilegio.
A pesar de la mafia, de los malos, de los muertos, de las drogas y de todo eso, hay una parte humana con la verdad del sentimiento que sostiene una relación de amor, y a mí eso me encanta y me parece hermoso. Ojalá sucediera más en la realidad.
En algún momento Leti se entera de que el dandy José también está involucrándose ya con otras mujeres, que se ve.
Ay, ¿por qué me haces esa pregunta? No es que si me entero. Si
Leti se entera de las otras relaciones que tiene José el dandy.
Ella confía absolutamente en él. De hecho, hay una escena en que le dice que ella sabe que a pesar de que él no le pueda contar y que ella no sepa en realidad lo que está pasando, que ella está segura de lo que ellos han construido y de lo que ellos son, y que sabe que ninguna mujer va a poder romper eso, ¿no? Y bueno, se involucra tanto y se confunde tanto con sus otras realidades que si sucumbe ante... la carne es débil. Leti no se llega a enterar. Sí siente celos de una mujer que viene a la casa a preguntar por él, pero como luego esta mujer la va a ayudar un poco a ella en un momento muy difícil, pues no, como que no es una mujer desconfiada, y son tan importantes las otras cosas que no está perdiendo tiempo y energía en pensar si su marido es infiel o no. Ok, por momentitos te lo planteas, pero muy corto, en tantos episodios.
¿Qué significa para ti, para tu carrera profesional, poder interpretar a José Montaño y a su vez a Daniel el Dandy?
Yo creo que seguir trabajando. Y seguir trabajando es un gran privilegio. Y trabajar en un proyecto interesante con actores interesantes, con directores que yo estimo mucho y que son grandes directores también, como es el caso de Mauricio Cruz, como de Chava Cartas, pues me hace sentir muy afortunado, y que me den la confianza y la posibilidad de poder interpretar a este personaje, que de alguna forma lleva como un poco la batuta, pues es una gran responsabilidad y también es un gran privilegio. Pues sí hubo una preparación de por medio, sí de alguna forma hubo una preparación física, pero no fue como tan buscada y tan buscada para el personaje. O sea, era algo que de alguna forma con Chava, por ejemplo, él y yo ya habíamos hecho una serie de policías, una serie policíaca, y pudimos explotarlo de otra vez. Porque recibimos un entrenamiento y dijimos, mira, nos volvimos a encontrar y ahora estamos otra vez haciendo lo que en algún momento nos entrenaron. Y afortunadamente pues nos fue muy bien y lo disfrutamos mucho. Okay. Disfrutamos mucho el hacer esta serie.
Escenas muy apasionadas. ¿Cómo fue trabajar con Poncho también? Esta química que tienen ustedes fuera, y se ve que también dentro, en los reflectores... ¿Cómo fue trabajarlas?
Creo que alguien hizo una pregunta que también esto iba por ahí. Al principio fue un poco, para mí, incómodo, en el sentido de que estaba yo un poco tensa la primera semana, sobre todo porque no me había tocado antes hacer escenas así con tanta intimidad. Lo bueno es que él ya venía entrenado con el Silvestre. Él ya venía con todo, ya sabía todo. Y me decía, no te preocupes. Pero la primera semana, que no nos conocíamos y que no, sobre todo como si había escenas muy, muy, muy íntimas. Y yo creo que al principio éramos un poco torpes, era así como de, aquí tienes que cargarle, y éramos así como unos robots, así de, ¿pero qué? Y entonces me acuerdo el asistente diciendo, ¿pero qué están diciendo cuando yo estaba cargada, no? Entonces al principio sí fue un poco, simpático, raramente simpático, y conforme fue avanzando, que ya fuimos como conociéndonos un poco más y pudiendo... compartir un poco más desde la realidad para crear la ficción, Entonces sí se hizo como más, me cuidaba mucho, me decía que si me sentía incómoda con algo, me tapaba, si algo se podía ver. Entonces sí me ayudó mucho, fue un gran compañero.
Es una gran profesional, es una tremenda profesional, ha sido y fue un placer trabajar con ella. Es una actriz que es muy generosa, y pudimos lograr cosas muy interesantes en el set, muy muy interesantes. Y recuerdo muchas escenas que de repente los dos nos sorprendíamos en no lo digo de esas escenas, lo digo en general. Donde de repente la ensayábamos y la platicábamos y como decíamos, botábamos la línea y al momento que terminábamos nos quedábamos sorprendidos y de repente encontrábamos cosas que decíamos, ¿y de dónde vino eso? ¿Me explico? Sí. Y eso fue algo maravilloso y lo agradecimos los dos.
Mis expectativas se basan en que la gente pueda disfrutar de todo el esfuerzo y de todo el trabajo y de todo el cariño que pusimos y de la historia de los personajes, ¿no? Porque al estar basado en hechos reales también te da como un fundamento distinto. Uh-huh. Y yo creo que las relaciones personales, que son lo más importante en nuestra vida y que es lo que nos transforma, tienen que cambiar a mejor. Y yo creo que estos personajes inspiran a que uno se replantee, estés en la noche viendo la serie y te replantees en tu vida qué está bien, qué no, qué quieres y qué, cuáles son tus valores, cuáles son tus principios. Qué, ¿no?
Okay. Para tener miedo.
Son dudas y esas dudas me dejan sin fuerza.
Sometimes you seem like a complete stranger to me.
People you are looking for have come from Spain.
Les vale madres los guardias que pongamos, porque el que lo va a matar ya está dentro.
¡Vamos!
Escolta, aquest actor que heu trobat, o que ja és un actor prou conegut, sí, però que aquí segurament serà la seva revelació, aquest xicot anomenat Herrera, com el trobes? Fas un càsting? Com arriba la pel·lícula?
And what's more, I'm shocked by the way they speak. It's so savage. I mean, the Spanish doesn't have the elegance of English, nor the precision of German, nor the musicalité of French.
Sentí mucho la muerte de Pablo.
Tu hermano es ya un héroe.
Espero que no me saque del frente, para que no termine como él.
Estic d'acord amb tu. A més, li deia, quan feien bromes, perquè sempre que surt passen coses grosses, no és la guerra, no és la... I li deia, és perquè estàs...
Luego lo celebramos.
Hola, soy Alfonso Herrera y tú puedes mirar el Dandy cuando tú quieras en tu dispositivo móvil ingresando a TNT Go.